Hello MechWarriors, how is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing medium lasers and I was thinking about a Wolfhound, but I recently did ER large lasers on the Wolfhound and then I was thinking about an Osiris and I was like, Osiris, yeah, but what about a Cicada? Guys, I haven't played a Cicada, let's go for the good old Cicada 2A. So why the 2A? Because it has 6 energy hard points, makes it so that we can put 6 medium lasers in there and a bunch of double heat sinks plus an XL engine 320. We are running at the same speed as a light mech and we have good firepower, and on top of it, because we are a Cicada and we are 40 ton and not only 35, we have some additional room for heatsinks. And wait, not to only the room but also the weight for heatsinks. So that's really nice. We can shoot that stuff forever. We have some quirks for the lasers. Let me quickly check that. It was energy range plus 10% and energy heat minus 5%, and that's okay, that's nice, nice to have. We can use the medium lasers as more or less extended range medium lasers. We can peek with that. So nice hit and run shenanigans, that's what we want to do today. You will see in the first game, this is a crazy skirmisher. It's so much fun to play that. And yeah, again, nothing crazy. Let me quickly talk about medium lasers in general, because I had some comments still about medium lasers. What about the medium lasers? Why am I so crazy about medium lasers? Because you get 5 damage for 1 ton. That's a very good tonnage to damage ratio. That's extremely good. That's super good. That's best. That's really, really good. 1 ton investment, 5 damage. You have 6 of them without ghost heat and you have 30 damage for 5 tons, 6 tons, sorry. And that's great. Of course, the heat to damage ratio is not the best. Of course, but again, the weight is so good. That means that when you have a build that runs, say, a cold ballistic loadout, you can always slap some medium lasers on top of that to amplify the damage by 5 each for only 1 ton. And that's why I like it. Anyhow, we got the skills. Let's talk about skills. We have a very straightforward laser vomit loadout here. So heat gen and the laser duration nodes, that's basically it. This is nothing crazy. You have seen that multiple times on the channel, guys. So if you go for lasers, then this is it. Cooldown is optional, I would say. You can take it, but in this scenario here, I didn't want because I had other priorities for these 4 points here. Namely, speed tweak. I like to go fast, and since we are running a 40 ton mech with a reasonably sized engine, we definitely benefit from the speed tweak skills here. Let's get them. Also, anchor turn, and I got a bit of torso speed here. I mean, why not? Now, we have the cool run maximized here, because we are running energy weapons only. That means they will rack up some heat. As I was saying, damage to heat ratio is not the best in the game. And since we have 6 of the medium lasers, this definitely makes sense. However, it's still good. Like, we can shoot for a long, long time before we even run into heat problems. We definitely want radar deprivation. This the 60% down here is probably what you want. You could go for more, but you had to sacrifice some points. Otherwise, then something like this here. Full radar deprivation as possible, and then the seismic sensor. I would say 1 point in seismic sensor is just a nice to have. 2 points is reasonable. So if you go down this path here, take the seismic sensor as well and then get this, because this gives you a great upgrade. But not today. And we are running double artillery for some long-range shenanigans. When we cannot get into range of our enemies, then we drop the artillery on the heads, or we use them to deny the enemies some area, and we have the double cool shot just in case, just when we need it. But I'm just thinking about it, I think I didn't really use them in the games that are coming. Anyhow, that's the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the 2 games that are coming, and if you have that, as always, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Crimson Strait and we are playing Skirmish. That means that we're gonna regroup with the team and, you know, we find a way to engage them somehow. I have to say, Crimson Strait is sadly not the most mobile and active map. It's a lot of peeking involved and we will probably struggle getting a good shot at our enemies here. However, we have a Piranha. And maybe we can do some backstabbing shenanigans with him. So that would be great. Also, 2 more light mechs coming in. I like that. Yeah, we have a nice light mech wolf pack here. Shall we go? Let's go. All right. So, bunch of light mechs and me. I mean, I'm a very confused light mech that just ate too much. The most important thing is that we do synchronize our engagement. So, let's see. We need... Yeah, that's a good target. We need to engage at the same time so that we can get a kill extremely quickly. Don't give away our position yet. All right, Mr. Piranha, I hope you're not too bloodthirsty. It's best if we worked together here. All right. There we go. We need to synchronize that, as I was saying. Oh, this guy's coming back. Are we spotted? That's an ER PPC, dude. All right, let's go. Yeah, we have to. All right, so the backstabbing attempt did not work out quite well. I drop artillery up there, because I believe that a lot of enemies are still sitting there trying to come at us now. And now we engage the Nova. At least the Nova cannot do his PPC shenanigans, thanks to us, basically. Thanks to what we do here. Yep, we got a good hit on his back there. So, second artillery is almost ready. Hi! Uh-oh. Ultra 2s, we can manage that. Yeah, let's go then, let's go. Coming in. No. A second artillery here. Going on Alpha. Your guys on the main force, could you push please? Because we got them distracted now. Would be great. Alright, the Nova. The Nova needs to die quickly. He in his position up there is actually quite scary. I wanted to hit the Nova, I didn't get the hit because the Akichita spider or something there blocked the shot for me. So, what can we do? Let's focus on the things we can do. You are pulling back, because it's a Mad Cat coming around here. Let's go in his back and shoot his side there to take it off. Let's shoot the other side to take that off as well. I'm gonna just splash the damage from the Kid Fox, retaliating a bit. And he's down, nice. You're sure about this, man? Vulcan? Kitty. Hi, kitty fox. Okay, side should be open. Yeah. The Kid Fox, although it can load a lot of weapon systems, although it has firepower and the funny build that he's running, it's still a light mech with no armor whatsoever. So, yeah, we do this. Continue our kind of crusade here against these guys. Oh, there's the Nova. Let's go. We need to get in his back once, and there we go. Nice. Keep track of what's going on the battlefield, guys. We knew that this Nova, I mean the one that we just killed, was extremely crit. So we could just do this, right? If we didn't knew that, I would have probably disengaged. Okay. So far, so good. Cheetah, how's he? Okay, side torso is open. Let's try to get it. He's doing us the favor of hovering in midair. Alright, alright. I think I'm gonna make this guy my target. Seems like a... Oh, I'm narked. Seems like a good challenge here. He, of course, has the ability to fly away from me. And what is this? It's another cheetah. Which is also very damaged. And he should also be very hot, to be honest. Okay, let's see. You're not gonna get away from me. Mmm, that laser burn was not good. I wish I could have a steadier aim on him. Okay. I mean, he should be... Yeah, there we go. Should be this... No! We did not get his side torso that I was aiming for. So now his heat management is completely thrown off. And we just go for the kill. Good. 7-4. Looking solid. This guy is a crit left side. Come on. Okay, we got that. And the spider. It's a very slow spider. Or am I just so fast? Okay, I have to turn around here. Because they were... machine gun fire. I was scared about machine gun fire, although it was probably just a scrape from my piranha buddy here. So he's open. That should be a kill against the Vulcan with the combined effort of the machine guns and the lasers. That's the cheetah from before. Ooh, what? Got that? Is the Vulcan dead? It seems like it, yeah. Okay, so where's the cheetah? There he comes. Again, his heat management is inferior to mine now, thanks to the loss of the side torso. What? That should have killed. Okay. Alright, we're gonna wait here. Oh, he overheated. And here's the spy. What a crazy skirmish, guys. I love that. Nice twist there, I gotta say. Nice twist. Are you going for my leg? I'm a bit afraid of him, I have to say. Yeah, because he has center torso kill capabilities. Uh-huh, I need a friend. Oh, no, not what I'm looking for. That spider transformed into a linebacker all of a sudden. All right, guys, get him. Get him, boys. That linebacker. So, what about Marauder? Okay, disconnected. Shadowcat. Oh, without weapons. Guys, this game is not over. Kid Fox, almost down. Play smart, guys. We have a disconnect and one guy without weapons. This is not over. please, don't throw it now. I mean, yeah, this Annihilator is fresh. This Annihilator is fresh and he should be able to shoot him. Yep. Although it was out of optimal range, it was still in range and he dealt still damage with the Heavy Gauss. Oh, come on, buddy. Come on, come on, come on. You can do it. There's another mech coming in from the side. Wait, wait, wait. I want to go for a Centurion here. Heavy machine gun, LRM. That doesn't help right now. You need another angle, buddy. You need another angle. Streak! Come on, you can do it! I know it! Is the linebacker going to win this? If he tries to get away from these guys, he can definitely win this. Like, if he uses his range. Ah, there's the streak. Oh, guys, please push in now. What is going on here? The Kid Fox, of course, being lagged and being super crit. It's not really helpful in this scenario here. He's just too slow, as well as the Annihilator. This guy is just disconnected. Uh-huh. And the Shadow Cat. Shadow Cat, go in. Block his signals. Go in. Use your ECM. So, let's see. He got the kill on the... He got the kill on the Centurion. That's what I expected. Here comes the Kid Fox. And he's going for the legs. Okay, it is an Annihilator against a linebacker. Okay, that was a good hit. You can do it, buddy. I mean, you're fresh. He cannot out-DPS you. It's all about your aim against his mobility. Let him come up again. And the Shadow Cat, you need to spot. Yeah, 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 let's go. Okay, good hit. Oh, guys, this is so tense. This is so tense. That's the weird part about it. Again, he has the chance to win the game. What is... I haven't seen such a game in ages. Again, let's go for the Shadow Cat. Maybe the Shadow Cat can give us some information where he's going. Shadow Cat, can you scout for us, please? Can you please... Holy cow. There he is, there he is! Shoot him! Nice one. Good hit. Bad, although we were 11-7? 11-7, guys. It could have gone down the other way round. Holy cow. Alright, anyhow, we got 3 killing blows, we got 9 assists, 4 Kilmos damage dealt, 805 damage done, and 13 components destroyed. That was a very nice skirmish. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, the second game of the day. We are playing Assault on the Frozen City. As you might know, I don't like Assault on the Frozen City, and I try to do something unconventional. Just to see if I can mix it up a bit, just to see if it works. Because I have no interest in staying in the back all the time. Shooting from one edge of the map to the other edge of the map, doing nothing. Especially with medium lasers. I mean, that's obviously not doing anything, right? Right. So, Echo 6 push is coming, you say? Oh, really? Oh, really? Well, maybe our distraction move did something here. So, this is what I want to do, by the way. I want to distract them. Mm-hmm. So that my team can safely go to the front line. Actually, they are pushing hard. What is that? Holy hell, guys. I didn't expect that from you. I need optimal range. Ugh, I need optimal aim as well. Didn't get it. What I got, though, is a Warhorn. Hello? I'm not here. No, 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 no. I'm just harassing you a bit. Hi. Oh, you got hit again. Oh, what was that? Some sneaky bastard from the outskirts. Oh, that's me. Hello, good sir. What's going on, dude? Are you happy where you are? Because I'm happy where you are now. On golf now. Okay, I have a problem. Ah, that problem is called Cyclops and Arctic Wolf. I tried to stop there for a brief second. For a very brief moment to actually mess with the aim. It kind of worked. Yeah. Sometimes not running like crazy, but stopping every now and then makes it so that the aim... Ugh, yeah, the aim is off completely. My aim is off as well. Okay, here we go. There's the Cyclops. Are you running Gauss? You are running AC... No, MRM... AC-20. Okay, okay, okay. I should be a bit scared of that. I should respect him at least. Here we go. Another shot to the side. That's what I'm going for the most of the time. And now we reposition. Just some nice hit and run shenanigans. Nice little hit and runs here. Aren't they beautiful? Happy little hit and runs. Okay, let's go for the leg. Goodbye. I'm out of here. I'm just leaving there. My team can mop him up if they want. Let's get out of here. Actually, let's go. No, no, no. Let's get the other leg as well. Sometimes it's better to... Oh. Bowser! You kill stealer. Bowser is the kill stealer here. Sorry, bro. Sorry. Love you, man. Alright. It's good to have him on the team. Okay, and one more to the side, and he should be dead. Oh, it was the wrong side, because I'm an idiot. Let's go for this side. Okay. And there is my friend, the Fafnir. Who has ultra autocannons and rocket launchers. An ultra autocannon of every type. Okay, interesting. I think I wouldn't go for it. Bowser, is he... Bowser? Come on, dude. If you're watching this here, are you specifically going for the kills? Waiting for the last moment to get them? This is crazy. He's getting all of them. Hi, buddy. Yeah, I'm not too afraid of him because I have friends. The power of friendship is strong in this team. And the power of the Bowser, of course. Mm-hmm. Who gets a kill? It's not Bowser this time. It's Sandman. Okay, so... You don't have to wait. This is what I want to show you with this video. You don't have to wait and install the game and do the base defend and just shoot long range. You can actually be very active in this here. And if you get a bit of distraction on the battlefield early on, it opens up some space for your team to push in, and then the enemies have already shot your skirmishes, which means their heat management is complete. The heat gauge is super high, the heat management is off, and then the main force, the murder ball, comes in, and then the enemies don't know what to do anymore because they cannot retaliate since, again, the heat is on. Now, we have 0 killing blows, but 8 assists, 2 kill most damage dealt, 579 damage done with 4 components destroyed. Let me check the amount of kills in Bowser. Oh, it's actually only 3. Okay. Anyhow, that's the daily dose for today, everybody. That is the Cicada with the medium lasers. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel. And if you want to support me, go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page, and I hope to see you guys on the battlefield. Goodbye.